The camp of detained former Senator Laila De Lima, confident the drug charges against her will be dropped soon. That's after a fifth witness recanted his allegations against De Lima earlier this week. Marcelo Adorco, who was presented by the prosecution as the bodyguard of self-confessed drug lord Kerwin Espinosa, claimed he was only forced to implicate De Lima in Espinosa's drug dealings.
Consistent ang pattern. At ang story nila, lahat nagja-jibe. Ang sinasabi, ang Department of Justice sa ilalim ni Rodrigo Duterte ay pinuwersa sila, tinakot sila, at nag-invento ng storya at nag-manufacture ng evidence. Hindi ba yun ang nakakatakot? Nakakatakot na ang Department of Justice mismo ang nag-iimbento ng ebidensya, nagpepwersa at nananakot sa mga witnesses, at ang mas nakakatakot pa dito, ang dami ng taong nagpagamit kahit na alam nilang kasinungalingan. This is the greatest frame up in Philippine history.
For Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara, it's better to let the courts decide on how these recantations by witnesses will affect the Lima's cases.
Ang Department of Justice naman ay nakahanda na tanggapin kung ano ang talagang lilitaw na katotohanan. Pero yung bagay na yan ay wala sa kamay ng Department of Justice lamang. Dahil yan ay nasa courts na. At yung mga hukom, yung mga judges, sila ang titingin kung ang ebidensya na nasa harapan ng korte kasama na mga pagbawi ng mga testigo na sinasabi ay dapat paniwalaan o hindi.
Here at home, a group of medical workers set to file a case against officials of Formerly Pharmaceutical. That's in connection with the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee's report on government's allegedly anomalous pandemic supply deals with Formerly. The report found certain acts were tantamount to violations of the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. The Alliance of Healthcare Workers plans to use that report as evidence when they file a complaint.
May plano na kami before yun ilabas sana yung resulta, kasi nag-usap na kami together with mga doctors, mga nurses, mga other health workers. Pero so far, kasi dahil alam natin na mayroon tayong kailangan doon sa magagaling na mga lawyer, so wala tayong nakitang mga lawyer na nagdagano talaga sa atin na sumusuporta para ituloy yung kaso. Pero so far, kung ganito naman ang mangyayari at pwede naman natin gamitin yung resulta ng investigasyon ng Senado, pwede natin gawin na mag-uusap kami with other health workers para kung kailangan ituloy talaga, ituloy. Kasi dapat may managot po. Kasi imagine ang daming mga Pilipino na mga napiktuhan sa anomalyang ito.
On Thursday, detained Formerly executives Mohit Dargani and Lincoln Ong walked free. Their release was approved after the Blue Ribbon Report failed to reach the plenary before the 18th Congress adjourned. The University of the Philippines dropped to the 129th spot in the list of top universities across Asia. Our correspondent, Ara Perez, on the line for details. Ara?
Beneath the Times Higher Education Asia University Rankings 2022 has announced top universities across Asia, including the University of the Philippines, which is at the 129th spot and lower than its 2021 ranking at 84th place, and the De La Salle University at the 401st to 500th spot in this year's ranking, similar to its 2021 ranking at the 401st place. Ateneo de Manila University was tagged as reporter this 2022, a status indicating universities that submitted data but did not meet the eligibility criteria. This year's ranking includes 616 universities from 31 territories. Asia's top two universities are Tsinghua University and Peking University in China, followed by the National University of Singapore, University of Hong Kong, and Nanyang Technological University in Singapore. In its website, the Times Higher Education said, universities are judged across all their core missions, teaching, research, knowledge transfer, and international outlook. Earlier, CHED Chairman Popoy De Vera said, participating in rankings on universities matters to enhance reputation, continuously improve programs, and pave the way for internationalization. Denise?
Thanks for that report, Ara.